best small cars with big power. Let's take a look at some small cars with big power that you can buy. If you haven't watched my previous videos, I'll link them down in the comment section. Before continuing with the video, smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm and a sub would be amazing. Flying Miata. Many people say Miata is always the answer. And generally speaking, if you say, how can I get the most amount of engine in the car, normally your best bet is to make a quick call to the Flying Miata lads. Chances are that a quick call would turn into a long and very costly call, which will then lead to a long and very humbling conversation with your significant other as they understand that you have invested the new sofa budget on a heroically overpowered small roadster. But who needs sofas when you have something that is custom designed to get you as much as possible out of the house? Your sofa, your TV, your stereo, nothing more than dust collectors if you possess an LS-powered Miata. It's just a case of how much strength you like and just how little self-control you can exercise because they are LS engines. Helpfully, the Flying Miata technicians fit improved brakes and so on to make sure you can, if not your own, control the insanity of the vehicle. Mercedes-Benz AMG A45. As far as we can tell, AMG is pretty much an eternal wellspring of titanically powerful engines. And while it's the V8s that understandably draw our most ardent affection, it's not like the engines that are half the size and have half the cylinders are exactly slouches, is it? Back when the first A45 came out, we nearly choked on our tongues when we heard its turbo 2-liter would be good for more than 350 brake horsepower. Then the insanity just kind of ratcheted up from there. First to more than 370 brake horsepower and then more than 380 in the new A45 and more than 410 horsepower in the A45S. This is just lunacy. An all new model of the Mercedes-Benz A45 AMG came out in 2020. It gets an upgraded 2-liter turbocharged engine available in two different tunes, mated to an 8-speed dual clutch automatic transmission. All models are all-wheel drive. The 5-seater hatchback's features include AMG alloys, sporty bumpers, power windows, electric mirrors, multimedia screen, navigation, CD or MP3 stereo, USB port, Bluetooth, cruise control, keyless entry, and other features. Standard safety features include front airbags, side curtain airbags, radar-based collision prevention assist, attention assist, stability control, and ABS. Other available features include LED xenon headlights, active parking assist, a rear camera, hill start assist, and an interior ambient lighting pack. Additional safety options include adaptive cruise control, adaptive high beam assist, speed limit sign assist, blind spot assist, and lane keeping assist. Is it necessary for a small hatchback to comfortably exceed 400 horsepower? Yes, in much the same way that it's necessary to use railway sleeper as a fly swat. Of course, it's overkill. It even verges on overkill. Where fans of regular overkill start to have second thoughts about just how dead the thing in question needs to be. Shelby Cobra. Formulas are not things that are necessarily interesting. Our eyes glazed over in high school and our minds went on Murray trips every time we faced with them. There is one recipe, however, that contradicts this dull trend. British sports car with American V8s. And can anybody say that the original Shelby Cobra didn't nail it out of the box directly? Yes, later on, they got bigger engines and bigger flares, fat tires, and all the stuff that almost every single remake and clone of an homage. But what about the original CSX 2000 Lite lines? It's utter heaven for us, and more than enough to match Ford's 4.7-liter V8, then as Carroll Shelby intended. Go out and blast the Corvettes into the weeds. Ford Focus RS Mount Tune. The most recent Focus RS is in no uncertain terms absolutely magical. It follows the same formula as the Mercedes AMG A45. Towers of power harnessed and delivered via four-wheel drive, but manages to do it with more of a glint in its eye and a smile on its face. Where the A45 is deadly serious, even if you're behaving like a buffoon, the Focus RS encourages buffoonery. Little wonder than the Australian fun police and also the actual police who are often difficult to distinguish. Jumped on its drift mode as a harbinger of the incipient hooning apocalypse and tried to get the car or at least the drift mode pulled away on sale. Even without drift mode, the RS remains one of the most entertaining hot hatches of all time. Does the 345 brake horsepower help? Well, it doesn't hurt, that's for sure. It seems, however, that the Mountune wanted to make sure if power was helping or hindering the Focus RS's fun factor. To do this, they've made merry with go faster tweaks until the 2.3-liter 4-cylinder engine is on the jaw-dropping side of 500 horsepower. 513 if you are the precise type. Lotus Exige. It is a little sports coupe with the Toyota-sourced supercharged 3.5-liter V6 engine. It gets go-kart handling thanks to the lightweight as well as its aerodynamics and aluminium chassis. In 2017, the Exige Sport 350 was introduced with better handling and slight visual upgrades. It is only available with a 6-speed manual gearbox as well as a 6-speed automatic. There are two new interior package options available, Premium and Premium Sport. The Premium pack provides added comfort and style, whereas the Premium Sport option focuses on creating an internal space optimized for ultimate driver involvement. A Lotus DPM, Dynamic Performance Management, switch allows the driver to switch between the three driving modes, Touring, Sport and DPM off. And if three dynamic settings are not enough, an additional Race Pack option is available, which adds a fourth driving mode setting, Race. This setting provides the maximum possible traction out of corners. The Race Pack also features launch control and an optimized suspension setting, making the car perfect for letting rip on the track. But then there's the Exige 430. So named because it sports 430 horsepower worth of supercharged V6 sitting right behind your head. This makes for a driving experience so eye-widening that your average Exige 430 driver is often mistaken for an anime character. BMW M2 CS. The BMW M2 made its debut in 2016. The exterior of M2 Coupe may look no different than of the M2 35i at first glance. But there are visual changes such as aggressively flared front and rear bumpers, quad exhaust and sporty alloys. As much as 80% of parts can be different when comparing M cars, the engine will be mated to a 6-speed manual or an optional 7-speed dual clutch gearbox. The car also receives M4 derived aluminium front and rear axles, aluminium suspension components, tuned electronic power steering and an active M differential. The longer M4 sourced axles are what led the M2 to have wider fenders, so the tires wouldn't stick out. And then there is the BMW M2 CS. But nearly 450 horsepower from a turbocharged straight six wedged into a car so small that it's had to bulge out in every direction to accommodate not just the very convincing go faster bit, but also the normal bits. Somehow BMW's designers managed to resolve all of that into something that's easily the best looking modern BMW. Admittedly, not very hard. But also a genuinely brilliant looking car. Megane RS. Equipped with a turbocharged 1.8-liter 4-cylinder engine, it comes with launch control. As for now, the manual transmission version is not available in many regions. The suspension sits 5mm lower than the GT and sits on a stiffer suspension setup. The handling is further improved with 4-wheel steering. The exhaust system also puts out a decent soundtrack, which adds to the fun factor. The exterior gets additional 60mm wings, front splitter, functional rear diffuser and full LED headlamps. For the interior, optional feature includes seats upholstered in Alcantara along with an Alcantara steering wheel, exclusive black headliner and red stitching. The center console features Renault's R-Link multimedia system with a big screen. Optionally, it gets Bose surround sound system with a subwoofer. The rear camera, front and rear sensors are standard. Safety features include front and curtain airbags, blind spot monitor, tire pressure monitor system, hill start assist, ESP and ABS. If you stuck around till the end, thanks a lot. It means a lot to me. If you enjoyed this video, I'll be doing a whole lot more videos like this in the future. So leave a thumbs up and a sub would be amazing. Also leave your thoughts down in the comment section. My name is Jitin and I'll catch you in the next one.